These two items right here were engraved with the exact same settings, the same image on the same material, but as you can see, one of them pops and the other one doesn't. This is a really, really great tip, and if you want to learn it, this applies to any laser engraver, not just the XTools I've got behind me. This will work with any laser engraver. Stay tuned and I'm going to show you exactly how. If you find yourself laser engraving on wood a lot and you often get a bit of a washed out image and you're not sure why, then this is going to really help you, because you find with a lot of materials, I mean, this is a pine coaster, but you find with bamboo and other types of wood, sometimes it's a bit inconsistent and it was also washed out quite a lot. But I have got a really great trick which is going to turn that washed out image and give you guaranteed results every single time, and also just make it look so much better. I'm going to show you the setup process, then we're going to run through the first engraving just to show you the normal steps you would take. Then we will run through the second engraving, showing you the secret ingredient. And I promise you, it's an easy one to follow. So if you are a beginner, you're in the right place. I'm Chris, this is L3D Accessories. Let's have some fun. We're gonna place our item straight in the self-centering jig. This always helps because you wanna know where your item is, and this guarantees it. We're gonna import our SVG vector image. If you wanna do this right, a vector image makes it a great place to start because you can scale it up and down infinitely and it retains its quality. That's perfect when you wanna engrave. So we've got it positioned. The XTool material library is great for this, by the way. The pine coaster settings work out the box. However, I've refined mine because I like to have a darker engraving. So there you can see my settings. We're gonna frame the item just to make sure it's positioned exactly where we want it. It always needs to be central or else it just looks a bit odd. There we go, everything's set up. So we're gonna click process, and as you can see with this one, it's a 3:59 engraving. There you have it. So there is absolutely nothing wrong with this, by the way. If that's what your engraving looks like, it's fine. However, we can make it better, and we are going to make it better. So let's load our second log in there. It's a slightly different shape, slightly different tone, but it doesn't matter. We're going to put it in central again. We are then going to reposition it in the XTool Creative Space software. And as you'll see right here, we will be using the same settings that we just did: 100 power, 400 speed, and 100 lines per centimeter. I want this to be as close to possible so you can really see it. Let's frame the item in there again and let's click it off, and it should be the same time. You'll see right here, it is 3:59. We will now move on to the secret sauce. And the first thing I will say is do not touch the design. Do not touch the log. Leave everything in the same place. What we will do then is select the image and click over to score. That will now draw a load of lines around the outside of it. It's the equivalent to coloring and outlining it. I use these settings, but once again, you can use the material library settings. This is our secret sauce. Trust me when I say this, it makes all the difference. So let's get it started and enjoy this, because I promise you it is very satisfying to watch. And there we have the final finished product, and it is looking great. There you have it then, guys. I've taught you a new technique and I really hope you can put it to good use. If you make items for fun, if you sell them, this is gonna be beneficial to you. And like I said, I may have done it on the XTool Creative Space software for the XTool machines, but this works with light burn, it works with any laser because the concept is the same. And it is just a great way of making those images pop. If you've enjoyed this, you've got something out of it, please like the video first of all. Please subscribe to me if you haven't. And feel free to comment below and let me know how you got on, because I always love hearing from you guys. Stay tuned for more great videos in the future. Thank you very much.